Everyday people ask themselves why they weren't born rich, why they don't have time or money to go on vacation or have a big house. Still, the thing is that those people don't stop regretting and don't take action to change their life. On the other hand, we have the people who see life differently, people who don't regret that day by day decided to change their life somehow. Thanks to this, today we're gonna show you how to start becoming that successful person, and what better way than telling you the top 10 things that these incredible people don't spend their money on. The first thing that successful people don't spend their money on are brand new cars or getting a lease frequently. This happens because a new car loses 10% of its value in the first month after purchase it, and 20% after its first year. People who manage their money correctly will not accept that loss, and know that value and money relation are much better in a used car that is between 5 to 10 years old and has already suffered its maximum period of depreciation. And with the lease, you still have to pay a down payment, and although the monthly payment is lower, so you will own nothing compared to the loan. The second thing is that they don't spend money on houses they can't afford, and only seek to buy a house that they can easily have the money for. In a study by Sarah Stanley, shown in her book The Next Millionaire Next Door, which interviews over 600 millionaires, she realized that the vast majority live in houses below their means. None of them have spent over 5% of their fortune in their home. An example of this is Warren Buffett, who lived in a house he bought in 1958 for $31,500, which today is $270,000 and represents only 0.0003% of his $82.1 billion fortune. By the way, if you are interested in knowing more about this legend, I recommend you watch the video that shows on the card. Let's continue. Another reason to not buy high-value homes is that you have less money to save or invest, limiting your opportunities. The third thing is that they don't buy things with a credit card they can't afford. Either a purchase of $1,000 or $10, they never pay interest, and this is because they buy things that they can typically pay, so they don't delay in paying the card, and either way not charge with interest that can be up to 25%. The fourth thing that wealthy people don't spend money is on expensive clothing. Many wealthy people who are not related to frequent public appearances prefer not to spend money on expensive clothes. Recall how Steve Jobs wore the $10 watch of Bill Gates. This is because most people buy expensive clothes to prove others they are rich, while the rich already are and don't need to prove it to anyone. Also, they have better uses of money than just clothing. In particular, the wealthy 1% is spending less on material things since 2007. The fifth thing is not to fall on impulsive purchases. How many of us have seen something beautiful that we don't need, but that is on discount, and we regret after buying it? It happens to many of us. It's one habit that makes the difference between the billionaires. One extra pair of jeans will not make any difference. As Warren Buffett said, if you buy things you don't need, soon you will have to sell things you need. One way we can avoid this expense is to make a shopping list before going to the store, and we only spend on what we have already written. The sixth thing is that successful people don't buy the latest electronic gadgets regularly, and it's because the previous version works, so they don't spend money on a fresh one every year. Electronic gadgets that lose their value in the blink of an eye barely justify the money that has been spent. There are also the one-time purchases, such as machines to make ice cream, crepes, yogurt, among others, that are used one or two times. And when they hang around the house without being used, it's money that we already lost in these useless articles. The seventh thing is the wealthy knowledge. There is a slightly different between free education and private paid education. Success in life is only achieved through discipline, determination, and perseverance. But some people believe that if they pay for education and receive a diploma, they will buy a ticket to a successful life. As a result, young people take out a huge loan to pay for their education, and after that they have to work for the next 5 to 10 years to return back that money. In effect, a young American at the end of college has an average debt of $30,000. The eighth thing is that they don't buy a lot of toys for their children. Middle-income people often indulge their children by filling their rooms with trendy toys that are bought whenever the child wants them. The millionaire children will have drowned in toys if their parents had satisfied their every whim. Rich people prefer a reasonable expense and don't buy a new doll just because it appears in advertising. Studies confirm this. 36 children were offered to play in a room for half an hour with 4 existing toys. And they found that the children in the first group with 4 toys were much creative, that they came up with more entertainment and fewer objects. The 9th thing is that they don't consume junk food, since the wealthy are upset with healthy eating. The most crucial difference between a millionaire's menu and what the regular income person usually eats is not the cost of food at all. They can eat the same cereals and vegetables as mere mortals, but they are unlikely to eat mayonnaise-rich salads, hamburgers or fries. And this is because they know that health is worth more than any amount of money and is the most essential asset that a person has. The last thing successful people don't spend money on is lottery tickets. If you truly want to strike you rich, don't play the lottery. This is a sure way to burn money fast. And productive habits don't include a weekly stop at the convenience store lotto line. Your chance of winning the Powerball grand prize is about 1 in 292 million. Those odds are not in your favor. Look at the math. A Powerball ticket costs $2. That might not seem like much, but if you play twice a week for a year and buy 2 tickets each time, you'll have put more than $400 in the hole. Don't waste your hard-earned money on chance when you can put it toward wealth-building goals. Many studies have shown that people who might be considered low-income play the lottery much more regularly than higher-income people. So, start thinking about it. Do you need to start changing something? Well, now you know from where you can start.